What's going on, my Boxchevy family? It's Boxchevy Pete back again with another one. We up and at it early, man. I'm heading to this damn junkyard. Don't you bring your ass out here. I'm headed to this damn junkyard, man, to get the steering column. I attempted to put it in and to no avail. It was just too loose. And the screws that was supposed to be loose in there that I was supposed to tighten was missing. So I'm just go ahead and grab another one and slap it in and call it a day. So I'm headed there now. Cut y'all back on in a minute. Let's go. Well, yeah, I'm waiting now. I'm in here. Waiting to see if we can get it. Okay. Yo, y'all got something pulled, though, I'm pretty sure. Okay.
Back at the home front. This is the new steering column. Not too bad. Not too clean either. Excuse me for this camera angle. I got one hand, man, so y'all gotta forgive me. But yeah, it's decent. Sit it down right here. It's decent. Like I said, y'all know that steering wheel is not gonna be on here. This rusty ass thing. I just ordered for lead pieces for this, so I got this and this for lead. Order me a brand new turn signal, but other than that, I'm about to go ahead and grab this trusty paint, wipe it down with soap and water and dry it, and I'm gonna go ahead and spray them up so I can go and install it. As y'all can see, I've been hard at work tearing some shit up. See all those parts? I took this thing apart and it was done. Yeah, I could have put it back together, but this damn thing ain't working, so I'm gonna leave it just where it's at. Paint this other one up. Got the trusty spray paint. This is the best spray paint I ever had, too. This two times Ultra Cover Rust-Oleum. This some good paint. Got the easy spray nozzle. It stick to everything, too. Like, you know how you get the spray cans with the spray nozzle like these right here? This is the caliper spray. See these? I be having trouble with this paint. It don't stick to stuff. This Coverall, it cover everything. That's why I love it. See, I got the red one down there, and I got a few of them up there. They're my favorite ones, the Rust-Oleum. They cover everything. But yeah, let's get this started. No, I'm not getting paid for these ads, which I'm pretty sure y'all know I ain't getting paid for the video. So let's get to work, man. So take this little screw off. Hazard joint. Can't afford to lose. I'm trying to one hand this for y'all. Boom. Wipe it down with a soapy rag. Get all the debris off here so I can have a nice clean paint job. You know. Dry him off, let him dry. Then we gonna spray just the neck part. So I hit it with the first coat. I'm only gonna do two coats on this, since this double it. Basically, like I'm doing four coats since it's double the coat. Double the thickness, so I'm gonna do one more coat after this and maybe turn it over and stand it up the other way just to make sure I ain't missing nothing on the bottom. I moved it around, but yeah, so that's the first coat. Gave me hell, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, but I think it looked pretty good. What y'all think? Let's turn that down a little bit. Think it look pretty good though. What y'all think? Simple. Of course y'all know when I buy my rims, I'm gonna buy another Ballet steering wheel. This just look better than the factory to me. You know, and as y'all see, the front dash is out. because it's getting wrapped. The dash and the door panels, front and back. Front one was coming loose. The back ones was actually still in pretty good shape, but couldn't get those wrapped and then have them a different color from the back ones. So I just had them rewrap all of them. So basically all the dash and the door panels, they're gonna be the same color as this console and the steering wheel, just to tie that in, because that gray was, I picked that color gray over the phone trying to match it up, and it was a little brighter than I wanted it. So they ended up, I ended up having to get that one wrapped the same color too, basically. So yeah, that's gonna tie it in there with the other one, but I just waiting on them to get the door panels and that dash back, and then we gonna be set. Other than that, it's straight though. Painted it up, cleaned it up, wired it back up, rewired the remote starter back up. He good to go. It's always good to know how to do some shit yourself, man. Yep, and I'm getting this back deck made soon too, so yeah, be ready. So I'll be giving y'all an update on that motor. I got everything. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna let y'all check everything out now. Hold on 1 second. Yeah, so we headed to go pick up the dashboard and the armrest right quick. He said he got both of them ready for me, so me and Lil P gonna shoot out there and go pick it up right quick. So we cut y'all when we get there. Y'all see I got my tire pressure light is on for some reason. I think I need a sensor in the driver's side wheel. But that's another story for another day. We'll cut y'all when we get there. So as y'all see, I'm back. Got all the pieces back. Armrest. Got them wrapped. These the front. See, use the same material to get them to match that, just to tie in the console, since they didn't match with nothing else. I figured I'd tie them into this to get them to match. That go for the passenger side though, but I'm gonna change these locks out right quick. I got those brand new. Let me grab them. So as y'all see, I got them. Some new replacements, which look much better than these. I initially got these for the blue box Chevy, but I ended up getting this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and use them for this now since we cleaned it up. But yeah, we just tying it in with that. See the dash wrapped as well. I was wondering what I was gonna do with these dark gray vents. I was gonna paint them, but I think I'm gonna leave them this color because that still tie into the original color in there, seeing as if it's still dark gray on the inside. So it's light gray and dark gray, that'll be the theme. So it'll be this gray, and then that other gray match with this gray, so. The vents look better than I thought they would in there, so I'm gonna leave them just like that for now. Just keep it clean and simple in this one. So let me get these out and get all the stuff installed in the doors, and then get the dash installed, and I'm gonna cut y'all back on. Let's go. My fault, as y'all can see, I had to come in to the garage. Them damn bees is so bad. I don't know what's going on. There's a lot of bees out there. You see the water? I had to spray the ass the water hose. Take the garbage cans to the front. Look at them, see them? Look, they flying. Look at them dying. The bees is out here. I don't know what's going on with them. But yeah, I'm gonna show y'all something. Look much better with the new lock. It's just the small details in the car that just make it look so much better. That's the new one, that's the old one, as y'all can see. And we just tying everything in with that console. So that was the ideal I came up with. I figured I just, cause I'm like, damn, they really don't match. The grays is different, what can I do? So I figured I'd just wrap the dash the same color. And the armrest too, just tie it in with that. So it'll be dark gray, light gray. It'll be a couple different grays, but it'll look better than just seeing a gray console than a gray kick panel. I'm gonna try to install those kick panels too, maybe in the next couple days, but let me finish installing these armrests and then in the dash, and I'm gonna cut y'all back on. So we all done, got everything done. Armrest back on both sides. Front one on, I need to wipe this one down, it's a little dingy. That's the only thing I hate about this bright color, it's gonna get dirty real fast, but got that one in. Got the dash in there. Gotta get used to that bright ass dash, cause it was dark gray, but like I said, y'all see how I tying it in with that and the door panels. Got the speakers in there too. You see those dark grays, but I think those gonna stay. That's pretty decent. The other side. What y'all think about that squat game? That's how I'm gonna have it though. That's the level I'm gonna set it at right there once I put the coilovers on it. But it's squatting because I got all the stuff in the trunk ready to rock and roll with it. Got everything in the trunk ready to go. Wait, I'm looking for the button in here. There we go. Break-in oil, cam lube, all that good stuff. See, this is all the parts. This is the, right here, this is the AC compressor. This is the power steering. This is the chrome alternator. Pulleys in there, the belts in there. This kit was pretty expensive. Somebody looking to get one, they started like $1,500 on up, so. This one I paid like $17 because I got it ceramic coated. That way it'd be maintenance free. I can just wipe it off instead of having to polish it after so long. You know how you get the chrome stuff and it started to get dull and you got to polish it to shine it back up? This one is maintenance free, so I paid just like an extra $200 to get the ceramic coated one. That way you ain't got to keep, you know, trying to keep the maintenance up on it.